When you substitute r is equal to 2 in the equation, that concept we can call it as a the Euclidean distance. So wherever r is there in the equation, substitute it by 2. So in the equation, so now we are substituting. See, previously r was 1, so both it is almost equal to only this equation. Now we are substituting r is equal to 1 in the case of the Euclidean distance. So it is a xk minus yk square. So whole power 1 dividing by 2 means it is a square root only. It is a square root. So we are finding. See, 10, 0 minus 2, p1, p2. P1 of the x is 0, p2 it is a 2. 0 minus 2, it is a minus 2 square. Minus 2 square is a 4. Like that, 2 minus 0, it's square. 2 minus 0, it's square means it is a 2 square. So it is also 4. So 2 square is a 4. 4 plus 4 square plus, sorry, 2 square plus 2 square is a 4 plus 4. So power is 1 by 2. That is means a square root. So 8 square root means, so it is a 2.8. So this is how we are finding the value in the case of the Euclidean distance. The distance between P1 and P2 in the case of the Euclidean distance is, it is a 2.828. Understand? So this is how we find the difference in the case of the, with the help of the mathematical equation. So some of the equation we have, I'll show you. They are used to find the, what you can call it as a, the correlation between the two values or the two points or two datas. So like that, you can see P1 to P3. I have given it is a 3.2. It is a P1 to P3 is a 3.162. So it is almost equal to 3.2. I rounded it because 9 plus 1 square root of 10 is, it is a 3.162, it is almost nearly equal to 3.2. This is how we calculate. Please note down this. If you want, you can find out this also. P1 to P4. P1 to P4 in the Euclidean distances, it is a 5.099. So it is almost equal to 26. It is, one is, what you can call it as a P1 is, it is a 0 minus 6, right? P1 is 0 minus 5, it's square, 25, and 2 minus 1, it is a 1 square. So 5 plus 25 plus 1, it is a 26, 26 square root is, it is a 5.099. So P1 to P2 and P2 to P1 are similar. You can keep similar. There is a no distance of P1 to P1, P2 to P1, P2 to P3 to P3, P4 to P4. There is a no dissimilarity because they are similar only. That's what all values are zeros. So whereas P4 to P3, it is a 2. In the case of the L2, P4 to P3. So you can take P4 and P3. 4 minus 6, it is a 2, and 2 minus 0, so this is also a 2, so P3 to P4, what we are finding? 2, P3 to P4, it is a 2 only. In the case of the Euclidean distance, it is a 2, correct? Huh? 4 minus 6, this is 2 is correct? P3, P4, check it. Any one of you do it? P3, P4. So this you take P3 and this one is P4. P3, P4. 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5. This original table you have to take. This is the input what is given for all these problems. So 3 minus 5, it is a 2, 1 minus 1, it is a 0. So 2 minus the 3 minus 5 is a 2, 2 square. It is a 4. 4 square root is a 2. 4 square root is a 2. P3 to P4 or P4 to P3, both are same. It is a 2. Whereas in the case of the supernorm theorem, so what happens? Equation is same. Only the R value is tends to the infinity. That means if you have four parameters, so out of these four parameter, because R is tending to it is a finite, infinite. So that means the maximum values. The maximum values of the four is four parameter is that is a 5 in the case of the P1 P4. So P1 P4 it is a 5 in the case of the L infinity. P1 P4 it is a 5. Whereas in the case of the P1 to P4 it is a 5. P1 to P2. P1 to P2 it is a 2. P1 to P2 is a 2. Maximum values of the four parameters, 2x parameter and 2y parameter. So out of these four parameter, whichever is maximum, that distance you can take in the case of the supernorm distance. So many times question will be there. If you have a question paper, please refer it, because I had already distributed individually the hard copies of the three set of the hard copies of the question papers. Whenever my class is there, you please keep the question paper with you. University question paper. Because you will not find only in the book, no. Foreign books are there. They have given input table and the output table. So it is very difficult to find out the values of in the output tables. Okay, so if you know some of the values, how to find some of the values, and you can easily find out the remaining values in the examination, because it is you cannot remember when input is given, you cannot remember all these things. So only just you remember the equation for the Euclidean. With the help of the Euclidean, you can find out the man hat, you can find out the supernorm.